Greetings, programs. My name is Wretch, and I'd like to welcome you to Mortal Kombat 10, the newest entry into the fighting franchise. I've been a big fan of the Mortal Kombat series ever since playing the original cabinet many, many moons ago, and now I'm looking forward to giving this one a go because it's been hyped as the most bloodiest of all the combat games, and I'm looking forward to putting that to the test. So we're going to do a full playthrough of the story mode. We're going to do probably a chapter an episode, and just see where we go from there. I've played through the first chapter already. I'm going to go ahead and redo that now for you so you guys can see it. So let's do this.
Millions of years ago, Shinnok, one of the Elder Gods, turned on his fellow deities and invaded the Earth Realm. Raiden and the Elder Gods stopped Shinnok, locked him up in the Nether Realm. Others followed in Shinnok's footsteps, like Outworld's Emperor Shao Kahn, who was obsessed with conquering Earthrealm. So Raiden convinced the Elder Gods to enact the Mortal Kombat tournament as a way to even the odds, give Earthrealm a chance. For generations, Shao Kahn followed the Elder Gods' rules. The war moved to the arena, where he sent his toughest fighters to challenge Raiden's greatest defenders in Mortal Kombat. 2 years ago, we beat him. But Shao Kahn wasn't ready to lose. He violated the rules of Mortal Kombat and invaded Earthrealm. Most of Earth's defenders, our friends, were killed, turned into evil undead warriors. Despite the odds, we stopped Shao Kahn's invasion. As punishment, the Elder Gods destroyed him. We thought the long nightmare was over. But it turns out that Shinnok had been manipulating events. Shao Kahn's invasion, his death. All part of Shinnok's plan to escape the Netherrealm and resume his war on the Elder Gods.
So this is a bit of a prologue set when Shinnok was able to break out the first time from his imprisonment. And as you can see, it doesn't look like things are going well in Earthrealm, which is kind of a standard in the Mortal Kombat series. Now these flying demons are awesome. They remind me of one of the bosses in the original House of the Dead. Here comes the cavalry.
Destination, deadhead.
Set her down nice and easy for me.
Don't I always?
If by always you mean not once. Major?
You have the rendezvous coordinates, far edge of the forest. From there, we access the portal to Raiden's Sky Temple,
where there's an angry former Elder God and his devils waiting for us.
Gods, portals, flying demons.
Blind guys with magic swords.
The world has changed. For the worse, if we do not expel Shinnok from Raiden's temple, he means to poison Earthrealm's life force, the Jinsei.
And we're not gonna let that happen.
Kenshi and I appreciate the Major allowing us to join you. We're happy to help kick Shinnok's bony ass back to the Netherrealm.
It's good to see Kenshi back.
You gotta land this thing!
Oh, shit!
And this is how you can tell it's a prequel, because Scorpion's in his old costumes. Now, here's a little bit different. Real-time events. Or quick-time events, whatever you want to call them. Which is a new thing in these games, and pretty fun, too. I haven't failed one of these yet, because when you've been doing the Game of Thrones Telltale games, these are actually pretty easy, comparatively. It is different every time you play, I do know that. I'm pretty sure I'm pressing different buttons than I did the last time I played this. Nope. Flawless logic, Johnny. Tackling a teleporter on the way down.
The end is near.
Getting a little ahead of yourself, aren't you?
Now, we get right into it here. Now, I've done, since playing through the first chapter, I know a little bit about how to fight with Johnny. But we'll try and show you at least some of the really good stuff, like the Bone Breakers, and he has his typical moves, and that's one of the things I love about the MK series, is that the moves rarely change. So it's a lot of ease of play. And then we also have the awesome environment interactions like we saw in Injustice Gods Among Us. Which I'll try and show you guys here in a sec. But first off, let's break some bones. It's awesome. Is there anything here that we can interact with? There we go. And you can run. The fighting system is actually much more involved than I've seen in previous MK games.
Gotta get back to the chopper.
Sonya, get out of there!
There you go, Johnny. Get your Gordon Freeman on.
Whew, that was unpleasantly cold.
Oh, Sub-Zero's not messing around. Now, I'm not sure, is this like the young Sub-Zero, or is this the one that ended up being Noob Saibot? I'm not sure. I can't tell whether they've kind of retconned the continuity, or if they're just kind of telling a new story. No idea. Actually, I think Sub here is about to eat my lunch. Yeah, he is. Definitely seems that way. Any block the x-ray, unfortunately. Ooh! By the skin of my teeth, I'm playing this on medium difficulty, trying to get reacquainted with the fighting system. I haven't played a fighting game in a long time. Throw all the green. I'd like to see Sub-Zero still has some of his classic moves, like that barrier. Nice punch to the face to finish him off.
I liked it better when we fought on the same side.
Me too, Johnny.
You okay?
We fared better than the men.
Add him to the list of things Shinnok will answer for.
Now things are obviously going very badly at Raiden's temple. The Shaolin monks always get a horrible, horrible deal during these games. Now, obviously you know Raiden right off. It took me a sec to remember who this guy is. His name is Fujin. I think he was an unlockable character from one of the previous games. And he uses the power of wind while Raiden uses the power of lightning. As you can see, they're surrounded by a lot of badness. But I'm very happy that Raiden has his staff as his weapon of choice. He was disgusting with it in Deadly Alliance and in Deception. Shink.
Raiden, we must refortify the portal's defenses below.
No, Fujin. It is too late.
Now that's how you make an entrance.
The mighty gods of Earthrealm.
You be foul of these hallowed grounds, Quan Chi. Be gone!
Surely you are pleased to see your friends.
I was okay until I saw Cabal.
You abandoned them to their deaths. I returned them to life.
A life worse than death.
One you will soon share, and my lord himself shall witness your fall.
It was Stryker, Sindel, and Cabal there. And here you have the Shaolin monks, the red shirts of the Mortal Kombat series. And it keeps getting worse and worse.
Nightwolf!
And technically having to fight a battle on three fronts with smoke right there in the middle is no bueno. Oh, Anenra, sorry.
This is your last mission, son. The real Jax wouldn't punch his best friend.
Johnny Cage, killing you will be a pleasure.
We just gotta make sure that... trapeze artist. Jax can do a lot of damage really, really quickly, so we have to make sure that we distract or get away from him as quickly as possible if he starts getting on a roll. I want to save the Bone Breaker until we actually need it.
Don't say I never did anything for you.
And that ground crusher is the one that always gets me. So let's crush some bones in response. Throw a log. Shadow kick. Good old-fashioned uppercut.
We're gonna fix you someday.
And now he picks up a gun.
Well, nice seeing them again. Sonya, that's not him.
It's his stunt double. Johnny would know.
Sergeant, what is it?
Is that the elevator?
Yes, the elevator. Sento contains the souls of my ancestors. They guide me.
Orcs must be close.
Could they hurry the hell up?
Sword of Omens, give me sight beyond sight. There we go.
Going up.
Fall back, now.
Go on. You guys stay here. Close the door.
Now those guys are brave. I was wondering what was going on here initially, until I saw that. I recognized that attack. Boss man's here.
You see it now, Raiden.
Hello, Shinnok.
Your legacy. You poison their hearts with hope.
And what do you offer? The same as you did millennia ago, when you betrayed your fellow Elder Gods and attacked Earthrealm. We stopped you then, imprisoned you in the Netherrealm. We will do so again.
Remove the shadow from the light. The shadow grows. The legacy of life is death, Raiden. My followers accept this and live on. They fight for me.
Cool. Love Cabal, even in this zombified form.
Oh.
facehugger attack. And Striker. Striker's just horrible.
Oh, I will. And all of Earthrealm will learn the truth of death.
And that's the amulet that was such the big focal point of Deception and Deadly Alliance. Get some last-minute help from the cavalry.
Oh, sorry, ma'am. Didn't see you there.
Miserable wretch! Insignificant speck of feculent scum! How dare you!
And Kenshi is pretty much this series' Piccolo, I've noticed. He's just there to get shot.
That is mine.
Ready?
As always.
Some Neo versus Agent Smith moves.
She will be the first to join me.
No!
No! Johnny has this minty green flavor all of a sudden.
I'm not sure what just happened to me, but I am sure of this. You don't even think of hurting her.
Ow. I think he threw something at me. Oh, he blocked it. Dang it, or he shrugged it off. Let's see if we can turn the tide here. Apparently not.
Embrace the darkness.
Let's try that again. You and your fireworks. Okay, I can throw fireworks too. A lot of them, in fact. And tit for tat with the pot. And I don't know what the grab is over here. Oh, don't get me in a corner here, sir. There we go. 1-1.
I know you were such a fan.
Oh, now he is not playing around now. It still didn't help. Need to get out of this corner. Don't think our chances here are particularly good, guys. Unless I can start spamming, which I can't.
Judgment is at hand.
So let's try that again.
You don't even think of hurting her.
Again. Because you've already hurt her.
Hello.
If I have to be cheesy to do this, I will be cheesy to do this. There is no shame in this. Is that... Okay, that doesn't take any of my life. That's good. That's better. Shadow kick. Now we're using his abilities the way they need to be used. Now, can we break some Elder God bones? This will probably finish him off, too. That's more like it.
You really are a fallen Elder God.
Johnny's got the glow like in The Last Dragon.
Johnny Cage, the amulet!
I think Shinnok's very similar to Sauron with that amulet. If someone else has it, he kind of powerless against it.
Enjoy the new day.
Well, not like Sauron, but you know what I mean.
Sonya?
Johnny? Did we?
Yeah. We got him.
Remain here. The chamber's properties will heal Sonya Blade in short order.
Quan Chi and the others, they're gone. A surge of power within the chamber overwhelmed my senses.
We can deal with Quan Chi later, Kinshi.
We've netted a bigger prize this day.
Shinnok's amulet. And within it,
old Fishface himself.
Let us take the amulet to the Elder Gods.
They cannot destroy it. No one can.
They might offer counsel. Shinnok can never escape.
Hopefully they don't have to throw it in a volcano or something.
The war is not over. Quan Chi has escaped. Why are you smiling?
She called me Johnny.
In 20 years have passed.
I'm descended from some Mediterranean war cult. Bred as warriors for the gods. I've never been able to resummon that green halo. Raiden thinks it was triggered when I saw a loved one about to die. How about you, Cassie? Can you summon anything like that? Or did it skip a generation?
Take it easy, Jin.
We didn't need a halo in Darfur. Or Iran. Or Kurdistan. Did we, Jackie?
Nope, we didn't. Shaolin monks ever send you there, Jin?
I've seen plenty of action. Takeda and I both. Stuff that blow your special forces mind. At ease. You're all here because you deserve to be. You're beautiful and unique snowflakes. Now, as I'm sure you're unaware, judging from the lack of gift cards, today is our team's 6-week anniversary. Secretary Blake says he's pleased with our progress.
You could spit in his hair and he'd be pleased with our progress.
He was smart enough to have Mr. Cage put this team together.
I'm glad the Shura Ryu chose me to join. New places, new faces.
Got a group of young guns here.
Out, us older folks are going to retire someday. So it's time for your generation to step up. Shaolin, Shirai Ryu, SF. Together. For your team's first mission, you're going to the Lin Kuei Temple. We haven't heard from the Grand Master in a while, so we need to make sure he's still on our side. That he's got our backs if things flare up again with Outworld. You need to bring him in. But don't be surprised if Sub-Zero's not willing to cooperate.
Why be worried about Outworld? I thought Kotal Kahn respected the Reiko Accords.
He does, but he's facing a civil war. The rebels win, those Accords will be history.
Kotal Kahn. I think he's a new character. And here we are in Chapter 2. So I'm going to go ahead and end it here, guys. I hope you've enjoyed it. If you liked the video, go ahead and click like down below, subscribe to the channel, leave a comment, that'd be a big help, and we'll see you next time. Later days, everyone.